brothers, sisters, and our invited guests. Firstly, I give my profound thanks and sincere gratitude to Jehovah the Almighty God. Through our ransomer Jesus Christ, for the grace bestowed upon me to take on the sermon, look up to God. Look up to God. I also thank the acting president for this golden or unique privilege afforded me. The sermon, look up to God, is very, very necessary or timely in a time like this. The word look means to trust, to have confidence, or to rely on God. While God Almighty is no other than the creator and the possessor of the heavens and the earth, before whose majestic throne of justice we stand in awe this morning. This admonition, look up to God, is coined from the words of our Lord and Master Jesus Christ, as recorded in Luke chapter 21, particularly verse 28, which I will want us to consider. But before reading verse 28, read me verses 25 and 26. In the upper verses, our Lord and Master Jesus Christ, he gave a lot of prophecies. He spoke concerning the signs that will mark the end of this world, which includes international unrest, global wars, epidemics, and so on. Then he also spoke of the size of the second presence, the Parousia, and he warned the Jews that they, that is the Jews, that are called by the edge of the sword, and shall be led away as captives into all nations, and that Jerusalem shall be trodden down or occupied by the Gentiles until the times of the Gentiles be fulfilled. Then in verses 25, 26 and 28, they are body shots. Please read.
And there shall be signs in the sun.
Christ told us that there shall be signs in the sun.
Read on. And in the moon.
And in the moon.
And in the stars.
And in the stars.
And upon the earth, distress of nations.
The sun, the moon, and the stars are heavenly creation. But suffice it to say that the sun, the moon, and the stars, in the text under reference, stand for the three principal elements with which the devil is deceiving mankind. These are the elements of politics, commerce, and religion. Then he went further to tell us that upon this earth there shall be distress of nations with perplexities. Continue to read.
The sea and the waves roaring.
He went further to admonish that the sea and the waves will be roaring. In other words, there will be disagreement between the leaders and the led. And when you look at the world today, the leaders are complaining that the subjects are not obedient. And the subjects are complaining that they are oppressed by the leaders. So you will see that there is confusion. The leaders on their part are complaining. The subjects on their part are complaining. But look at most of these leaders, especially in the political circles. During their electoral manifestos or campaigns, they promise to build bridges in places where there are no rivers. They will promise the masses that they will build houses in places where there are no lands, and even to provide cars that won't be using fuel, but rather will be using water. But no sooner they are elected into power, they dash the oaths of the masses to the ground. Read on.
Men's hearts failing them for fear.
And by reason of this, the arm of men will begin to fail them for fear.
Read on. And for looking after those things which are coming on the earth.
When they look after the events that will be happening on earth, carry on.
For the powers of heaven shall be shaken.
For the power of heaven shall be shaken. Verse 28, please.
And when these things begin to come to pass,
we should take note of this. Christ then went to admonish us from where the sermon is going. That when we begin to see these things, these problems in the world that are facing mankind, look up. That we should look up to God. In other words, we should put our trust in God. And in putting our trust in God, it is pertinent that we come to the house of prayer. To cry to God. And by the grace of God, it has pleased God to help us to set up a unit here in Lekki Aja. When the members in this environment, they will be privileged to come to the house of God to commune with Him and to cry to Him. At any time that they have problems. So Christ told us that when we see these things, we should look up. Look up to God, read on.
And lift up your heads.
And that we should lift up our heads. In other words, we should praise the Almighty God through His beloved Son Jesus Christ. Read on.
For your redemption draweth nigh.
Because the time that God Almighty will deliver us is coming very soon. So we will see how important it is when we have a place for us to always come to commune with our Maker. I know that it has been the dream of the members who live in this environment for a very long time. But it is good for us to wait for God's time. And it is also said that God's time is the best. And even this day, by the grace of God, is the appointed time. In which God Almighty has allowed us to assemble there in Lekki Aja Unit to worship Him by His grace and power. The psalmist told us in Psalm 27 verse 14 of the need for us to always wait on God. But sometimes, it is easier to say, wait on the Lord, but how many persons actually wait for God's time? And that quality of waiting for God's time means that the person has trust in God and confidence in Jehovah, the Almighty God. It was God Almighty who told us in Isaiah 45, verse 22, that look unto me and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am God and there is none else. In Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 29, the Bible tells us that God Almighty declared that see now that I am He, and there is God with me. For I kill and I make alive. For I wound and I heal, and none can deliver out of my hand. So it is God that we should look up to. We should always call to Him, especially in the house of prayer, to commune with our Maker. And when you read the Bible, you will see eloquent testimony of men in the time of distress, in the time of trouble, who put their trust or confidence in Jehovah. I will begin with the case of the young man David. Please come to 1 Samuel chapter 17, which I read verses 45 and 46. This was an occasion when the Jews, they had war with the Philistines. And the Philistines, they had a giant known as Goliath, the giant of Gath. On that occasion, the Bible tells us that when the armies of Israel, they saw the size of Goliath together with his eyes, they became afraid. Instead of looking up to God, putting their trust in God, they became scared of the size of a man together with his eyes. And by reason of that, they gave him the opportunity to make mockery of the armies of God for good 40 days. It was young David who came to the camp. And he saw this uncircumcised Philistine who made mockery of the armies of God. Then David told them that he will fight Goliath. Even David's elder brother, when he had the hand of bias, he said that David has come to that place to display himself again. But David looked up to God. Read me 1 Samuel 17, verses 45 and 46. In fact, the Bible tells us that Goliath, he armed himself to the teeth. Please read.
Then said David to the Philistine.
Then said David to the Philistine, that was the giant of Gath, whose name was Goliath. Read on.
Thou comest to me with a sword.
Look at it, that Goliath came before him with a sword. Read on.
And with a spear.
And with a spear.
And with a shield.
And with a shield.
But I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts.
He looked unto God. My Goliath armed himself to the teeth. Continue to read.
The God of the armies of Israel.
So that at any time when we have this interest in life. At any time that we have problems in life, it may be sickness, it may be economic hardship, we could put our trust in God, just as David did. The Bible tells us that David told Goliath that even though you arm yourself to the teeth, I am coming before you in the name of the Lord of hosts. And that name is Jehovah. Continue to read.
Whom thou hast defied.
Whom thou hast defied. And it was the army of Israel, because of lack of faith in God, or trusting in God, they gave him opportunity to make mockery of God. Read on.
This day will the Lord deliver thee into my hand.
Look at the words of faith. Now this day the Lord, that is Jehovah, will deliver you into my hand. Read on.
And I will smite thee.
And I will smite thee.
And take thy head from thee.
And I will take thy head from thee. Read on.
And I will give the carcass of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air.
The corpses of the host of the Philistines. That he will give them to the birds of the air. In other words, the fowls of the air will feast upon their flesh. Read on.
And to the wild beasts of the earth.
And to the wild beasts of the earth.
That all the earth may know that there is God in Israel.
That the entire earth they will know that there is God in Israel. And really, when Goliath saw David, he wasn't just with a shepherd's bag, with 5 stones in it, and with a sling or a catapult. When Goliath saw him, he mocked David, that do you think that I'm a dog? Now you are coming to fight me with this sling or catapult? He did not know that David was coming to fight him in the name of the God of hosts. It was then David took a stone from the shepherd's bag and he placed the stone upon the catapult. When David drank the catapult, and no sooner or immediately he released the stone went straight to the forehead of Goliath. This stone does not just eat his head. The Bible tells us that he sunk into the forehead of Goliath, and this mighty giant, who was making mockery of the armies of the living God, before long, he don't let go for ground. In other words, he fell to the ground. When the Philistines, they saw that the man they placed their trust or hope upon had fallen to the ground, they began to fail. In other words, they began to run. And the Jews, they pursued them and murdered a lot of the Philistines. It was a great victory for the Israelites. Why? David looked up to God. No wonder he sang a very popular song. In Psalm 23, we, the acting president, also cited where he declared this service open, that the Lord is our shepherd, and we shall not want. That he maketh us to lie down in green pastures, and he leadeth us beside the still waters. He restored our souls, and leadeth us in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake, that yea, though we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, we shall fear no evil. For thou art with us, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort us. Thou God, prepareth a table before us, even in the presence of our enemies. Thou anointed our heads with oil, and our cup be runneth over. That for the goodness and mercies shall follow us all the days of our lives, and which are dwelt in the house of the Lord forever. And this is the house of God. We come here today for the first time to worship our Maker. It is a great privilege for us. Then I would like to make reference to the case of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Please go to Daniel chapter 3. To read from verses 1 right down to the end, but we shall read verses 14 through 18. Then from verse 24 right down to the end. It was an occasion when King Nebuchadnezzar made a gigantic image of gold. And he then issued a decree that at the place of various physical instruments, all mankind there assembled, they should bow down and worship his golden image. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego refused. Now go to Daniel 3, read 14 through 18. Verse 24, right down to the end, please.
Nebuchadnezzar spake and said unto them.
Nebuchadnezzar then spake and said unto them. Read on.
Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego?
Is it true, O Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? Read on.
Do not ye serve my gods?
Do not ye serve my gods? Who told that compared to don't go make that approach first? So make you know that that before I don't say what they need for war. In other words, they went to tell the king that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they refused to bow down, and they said that they would bow down to the holy image. Then he was asking them, that is it true that you, Shadrach, my God. Read on.
Nor worship the golden image which I have set up.
Nor worship the golden image which he, King Nebuchadnezzar, has set up. Read on.
Now, if you be ready.
Now, if you be ready.
That at one time ye hear the sound of the cornet.
That at any time they hear the sound of the cornet.
Flute.
The flute.
Harp.
The harp.
Sackbut.
The sackbut.
Psaltery.
The psaltery.
Dulcimer.
The dulcimer or the bagpipe. Read on.
And all kinds of music.
And all kinds of music. Carry on, please.
Ye fall down and worship the image which I have made.
You must fall down and worship the image that I have made. Read on.
Well.
Well.
But if ye worship not.
But if you won't obey.
Ye shall be cast the same hour into the midst of a burning fiery furnace.
That they shall be cast the same hour into the midst of the burning fiery furnace. Read on.
And who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand?
Look at the voice of a mortal man. Who opened his lips against the high heaven to make this kind of declaration that who is that God that shall deliver you out of my hand? Read on.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego answered and said to the king,
these three faithful Jews, their trust was in God, their hope was in God. So they answered and they said to the king, read on.
O Nebuchadnezzar.
O King Nebuchadnezzar.
We are not fearful to answer thee in this matter.
We won't be mindful to answer you in this matter. Continue to read.
If it be so,
if it be so,
our God whom we serve is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace.
The God that we serve will be able to deliver us from this burning fiery furnace. They have faith. They put their trust in God. Read on.
And he will deliver us out of thy hand, O King.
He will deliver us out of thy hand, O King. Carry on.
But if not,
let it not
be it known unto thee, O King.
Let it be known unto thee, O King. Carry on.
That we will not serve thy gods.
That they won't serve his gods.
Nor worship the golden image which thou hast set up.
Nor worship the golden image which the king of Nebuchadnezzar has set up. When the king heard of this, he became more angry. He ordered that the fire should be eaten 7 times than ever. He called for the mighty men in the armies of Babylon to burn Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in order to cast them into the fiery furnace. The Bible tells us that when these three faithful Jews they were bound, the armies of Babylon that took them in order to cast them into the burning fiery furnace, the heat of the fire alone consumed them. Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were in this fire without fault. Read it from verses 24 through the end, please.
Then Nebuchadnezzar the king was astonished.
Then Nebuchadnezzar the king became astonished, yes.
And rose up in haste.
And he rose up quickly.
And spake.
And he spake.
And said unto his counselors.
And he said to his counselor,
did not we cast three men bound into the midst of the fire?
Now the men that we cast into this fire, were they not three? Read on.
He answered and said unto the king.
He then answered and said to the king,
true, O king.
True, O king. Carry on.
He answered and said,
he then answered and said,
no,
that no,
I see four men loose.
That the persons that I have seen in this fire, they are four. Read on.
Walking in the midst of the fire.
They were walking in the midst of the fire. Continue to read.
And they have no heart.
And that they have no heart. Yes.
And the form of the fourth is like the Son of God.
He identified the fourth man. And God made the earth thing to understand who that man was. And he declared that he was like the Son of God. That was Jesus Christ in his pre-human existence. I want to draw our attention to something. Perhaps Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego may not be aware of the presence of the Lord Jesus Christ. So at any time when we are in difficulty, we should know that the angels of God are with us. Then why in the night, some of us will go to sleep, we are scared. The angels of God, they are on guard. Then why are we scared? The Bible tells us that the fourth man he saw was like the Son of God. Read on.
Then Nebuchadnezzar came near to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace.
Nebuchadnezzar then went close to the mouth of the burning fiery furnace. Continue to read.
And spake and said.
And he spake and said,
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Carry on.
Ye servants of the Most High God.
This was the man who made a statement earlier on. That who is that God that has delivered you out of my hand? He has changed his ways. That they are truly the servant of the Most High God. Read on.
Come forth and come hither.
And come hither. Yes.
Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Then Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Read on.
Came forth of the midst of the fire.
They came forth from the midst of the fire. Continue to read, please.
And the princes.
And the princes.
Governors.
The governors.
And captains.
The captains.
And the king's counselors.
And even the king's counselors. Yes.
Being gathered together.
Being assembled together.
Saw these men.
They saw these men.
Upon whose bodies the fire had no power.
Upon whose body the fire had no power. I will tell you, beloved brothers, sisters, and our friends, that when we look unto God, when we trust in God and even come to this house of prayer to commune with our God, the plots of the enemy, they shall all come to naught. Just as the fire does not have any effect upon Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, so likewise, God Almighty will neutralize the plans of Satan the devil and his agents. Continue to read.
Nor was a hair of their head singed.
Nor was an hair of their head singed. Continue to read.
Neither were their coats changed.
Neither was their coat changed.
Nor the smell of fire had passed on them.
Nor the smell of fire had passed on them. Continue to read.
Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said.
Then Nebuchadnezzar spake and said.
Blessed be the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego.
Then the strong God. This was the man who made the statement earlier on about God. That who is the God that shall deliver you out of my hand. Now he then extolled God. Read on.
Who had sent his angel?
Who had sent his angel?
And delivered his servants that trusted in him.
And delivered his servants that trusted in him. Continue to read.
And have changed the king's word.
And have changed the king's word.
And yielded their bodies.
And yielded their bodies.
That they might not serve nor worship any god.
That they might not serve nor worship any other god. Continue to read.
Except their own god.
Except their own god. Read on, please.
Therefore I make a decree.
The king then made a decree.
That every people,
nation,
nations,
and language,
which speak anything amiss against the God of Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego,
who will open their lips against the God of Shadrach, the God of Meshach and Abednego,
shall be cut in pieces.
They shall be cut in pieces. Read on.
And their houses shall be made a dunghill.
And their houses shall be made a dunghill. Continue to read.
Because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort.
Because there is no other God that can deliver after this sort. Carry on.
Then the king promoted Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego
to the province of Babylon. Instead of death, it became promotion for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. So what am I saying in essence? That in whatever situation we find ourselves, we should look up to God. And we've gotten this wonderful opportunity to have this roof under us, the house of God, where we can come from time to time to commune with our God, because we have no other person to look unto but unto Jehovah. I will round up with that. Read Psalm 91 from verses 1 right down to 8. In Isaiah chapter 26, verses 3 and 4, the Bible tells us that all those who trust in God, God will never desert them. Then in Proverbs 18:10, we are told that the name of the Lord is a strong tower, that the righteous run into it and it is saved. Then read Psalm 91, 1 to 8, I will round up with that.
He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High.
Let us take note of this. The Bible tells us that all those who dwell in the secret place of the Most High. When you talk of the secret place of the Most High, you are talking about salvation. Of which the most cannot decide it is the part and parcel of. Given to our industrial son from Africa, from Nigeria, from Warren, from Agbara, from Otomo, from the past century. May not the level of the text and the internet. The vessel of honor used by God to set on this great religious constitution in God's universe. And the better age of the church is the propagation of the self gospel of the kingdom, the fulfillment of Matthew chapter 20, verse 14. That is God's prayer. Of the kingdom that we preach in all the world as a witness to all nations and then at the end of it. It is by reason of the preaching of the gospel message that God Almighty is using his ministers by the grace of God to establish practice and truth, to expand the gospel message. And we thank God that even this day we are gathered here to open the lengthy. Continue to read.
Shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
And when we remain in God's holy organization, we can remain under the shadow of the Almighty. In other words, he will protect us. Read on.
I will say of the Lord.
And who will say of the Lord?
Is my refuge and my fortress.
He is our refuge and our fortress.
My God.
My God.
In Him will I trust.
In Him will I trust. In other words, in Him shall we look up to. Read on.
Johnny.
For that deliver thee from the snare of his power.
He shall deliver us from the snare of the power.
The wicked one. Read on.
And from the noisome pestilence.
And from the noisome pestilence. Continue to read.
He shall cover thee with his feathers.
The Bible then tells us that when we look up to God, when we trust in Him, He shall cover us with His feathers. Read on.
And under His wings shall thou trust.
And under His wings shall we trust. Continue to read.
His truth shall be thy shield and buckler.
Let us take note of this. Now the truth of God will be our shield and also our buckler. Read on.
Thou shalt not be afraid of it. Terror by night.
We should not be afraid of the terror by night. In the night, no redoubt our best to sleep.
In some cases, the wicked ones, witches and wizards, they are in their troubles. Sometimes they plan to take our lives, but they are surprised when they saw us. In the early hours of the morning, we are in and out.
I used to tell people that we don't know how many deliverance God Almighty is giving to us that we don't know. That we should not be afraid of the terror by night. Freedom.
Not for the arrow that flies by day.
And even the arrows, the missiles, fired by the devil and his angels upon people.
And when they fire those missiles, and the people of God, God Almighty will neutralize and turn them to nothing. Read on, please.
Not for the pestilence that walketh in darkness.
No. Or the pestilence that walketh in darkness, yeah.
Not for the destruction that wasted at noonday.
And even the destruction that wasted at noonday. Carry on.
A thousand shall fall at their side.
He then told us that a thousand that shall fall at our side. Read on.
And 10,000 at our right hand.
And 10,000 at our right hand.
But it shall not come nigh thee.
Look at the point.
When we put our trust and we look up to God, and through His will, no matter the danger that will come to this earth, it shall not come close to us. Read on.
Only with our eyes shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked.
Only with our eyes shall we behold and see the reward of the wicked. Carry on. Yes.
Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the Most High, thy habitation.
Because we have made the Lord, even our refuge, and the Most High, our habitation. Carry on.
There shall no evil befall thee.
Let us take note of this. When we look up to God, we trust in Him. No evil shall befall us. Carry on.
Neither shall any plague come nigh our dwelling.
Neither shall any plague come nigh our dwelling. I used to say it. That when we trust in God, we look up to God, if they give us poison, it will cure the people so in our face. It's a matter of faith. Read on.
For he shall give his angels charge over thee.
For he shall give his angels charge over us. Yes.
To feed thee in all thy ways.
And they will keep us in all our ways. With this, beloved brothers, sisters and friends, I will stop on the sermon. Have God look up to God. I thank you all for listening. Thank you.
Brothers, sisters, and friends, we thank God Almighty for helping him to have discussed that subject. Protocol says that when we want to talk, we should remove our mask. And that's why I'm removing mine. The choir, they have a special song which they're going to render. But before they do that, let us all rise and take TSB 3-0. It's a popular song. God of mercy, God of justice. Let us hear that song first. Then the choir will now give us that special condition that they have. God of mercy, God of justice.